Vasco da Gama discovered India. We have been saying this for decades as if India never existed before Vasco da Gama. Let me tell you a story, the fact about why and how Vasco da Gama came to India in the first place. Why the world wanted to visit India. Make sure you watch the whole video to know the most important part of the story. For thousands of years, India had commercial relations with the West. Earlier, the trading used to happen by land. But in 1453, Turkey captured a place called Constantinople, which was like a gateway to connect the Europe to Asia. And the Turkey closed the pathway for European traders and demanded the Europe to buy the goods they brought from India, which was sold at a 3 times costlier price. Even those who had permission to use the pathway had to pay a high fees to get through. So they badly wanted to find a new route to India. Many sailors and merchants from the West wanted to find a sea route to India. Even Christopher Columbus in 1492 accidentally reached America. What he really wanted was to reach the land of India. The whole Europe wanted to find a sea route to India because the goods from India were in great demand in Europe. Especially the spices were in much demand because it can be used as preservatives during the harsh winter seasons. Most of the trade that happened with India was either by land or via Arab merchants who sold the Indian spices for a much costlier price to Europe. The land journey was expensive and the capture of Constantinople reduced the trade to a great extent. So for Europe, a new sea route to India would mean more profit and better access to the Indian goods. It would also give them a monopoly over the profitable spice trade. So King Manuel I of Portugal sent a team of 170 men with 4 ships to India, and Vasco da Gama was appointed as the captain of that expedition. The fleet departed from Lisbon on 8th July 1497. The plan was to go around the continent of Africa and then reach India from there. After crossing the Cape of Good Hope, they halted at several places, but they were not welcomed there and the locals forced them to leave the place. As we know already, Vasco da Gama was not a great man. So while departing from the islands, they fired back the cannons towards the people. And finally, they halted at a place called Malindi in Kenya, and there they met an Indian sailor who helped Vasco da Gama with the directions of India and also informed him about the difficulties of monsoon season. With the help of that Indian sailor, on 20th May 1498, Vasco da Gama reached a place called Kappad near Kozhikode in Kerala. That was then a part of the kingdom of Manivikrama Raja, who was also called as Zamorin, which means the king of ocean. As we all know the hospitality of Indians, Vasco da Gama got such a grand welcome in Kozhikode. But King Zamorin was little upset with the gifts as they brought basic things like clothes, sugar, oil and other things. Indians wondered why there was no gold and silver. Above all, Vasco da Gama had such an audacity that he refused to pay the routine custom duties to the kingdom. This obviously annoyed the king. And the Muslim merchants were also not happy with their arrival because they would be their potential competitor in the business. After 3 months of stay, they left India. The journey was so tough, only 2 ships out of 4 sailed back. And out of 170 men, only 55 went back alive. The Gama was given a hero's welcome in Portugal and was given the title Dom by the king. The goods sent by the Indians was valued at more than 60 times the expedition's cost. That's how rich India was. In the first place, the Portuguese kingdom struggled to fund their expedition. It was not easy for them. But here in India, a king of a small place, he was not even an emperor like King Ashoka, Chandragupta Maurya. He was a king of a very small kingdom, sent them back with the goods worth more than 60 times their expedition's cost. That's how rich India was before the invaders. And here, we are teaching our kids that Vasco da Gama discovered India, as if India never existed before Vasco da Gama. The Indian heritage is one of the world's oldest civilizations. The Indus Valley Civilization, which was 5,000 years ago, had an elaborate drainage system. The rest of the world must be hunting down in the caves that time. India was the wealthiest nation in the world before the British happened to us. The agriculture was so rich and the trade with foreign lands was on a boost. Not just the economy, with spiritual and philosophical knowledge, we were the world leaders practically in every sense. And finally, no one discovered India. Let's get that straight. The Europe wanted to have trading with India for the sake of their own well-being. And when a Portuguese kingdom struggled to fund an expedition, here a small Indian king sent them back with the goods worth more than 60 times their expedition's cost. That's how rich India was before the British happened to us.